Hello students, so welcome back. Today we are going to discuss another concept from principles of inheritance and variation. Today's concept is crossing over. The breeding experiments carried out on Pisum sativum and Drosophila showed that even linked genes do not remain together in successive generations. During prophase 1 of meiosis, there is an exchange of parts of chromatids between homologous chromosomes. So once recollect that this prophase 1 in meiosis is subdivided into 5 sub phases, 5 subphases. During this subphases, the crossing over is takes place. That means exchange of parts of chromatids takes place between the homologous chromosome. So chromatids means suppose if you see this this structure of a chromosome here. So these arm-like structures are called as the chromatids, and these two chromatids are joined at the center. It is called as the centromere. So chromatids, this is a chromatid and it is a centromere. So now during prophase one, the chromatid parts are exchanged. So the chromatids of homologous chromosomes cross over at certain points called as chiasmata. So now already we discussed during mitosis and meiosis time. So suppose this line is a one chromatid of the chromosome. So this is the another chromatid, that means chromatid of another chromosome. So now during crossing over, the chromatid of this chromosome is crossed with this one, and the chromatid of this chromosome is crossed with this. So now this crossing region, this region is called as chiasmata. So the chromatids break at this chiasmata and then rejoin. So at this region, the chromatids are broken and rejoins. So then how it will appear? So this this chromatid appears, some part it is a blue and the remaining part, that is exchanged chromatid part. And similarly, if you see this one, and this is appears like this. So when the two chromosomes, that means chromatids, one is this one, this is a chromatid of one chromosome, and this is a chromatid of another chromosome. These two are undergo crossing over, and this is the result of the crossing over. So that means it form first chiasmata. At that region, the chromatid is break and rejoins. Crossing over results in the exchange of corresponding segments of chromatids at the same locus between the maternal and paternal chromosomes or non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosomes. As a result, along with the parental kinds, new types of gametes are produced. They are called recombinants. So that means recombinants are formed due to the crossing over between the chromatids. when crossing over occurs between the chromatids, the exchange of genes or genetic material it takes place. The recombinants have a new combinations of genes on the same linkage group. The recombinants have new combinations of genes on the same linkage groups. So note the important concept here. Each crossing over results in two parental and two recombinant types of gametes. So each crossing over results two parental and two recombinant type of gametes, because at any particular crossover only two chromatids are involved in the mother cells which undergo meiosis. So in each crossing over only two chromatids, that is so in a homologous pair is nothing but two chromosomes. This is one chromosome, and here it is another chromosome, two chromosomes. So in this, between these two chromosomes, the crossing over occurs. As a result, what we are saying, two parental as well as two parental and two recombinant types are formed. Recombinant types of gametes are formed. This we are seen in the dihybrid cross. Suppose so there capital R small r, capital Y small y. So in this capital R gamete, capital Y, capital R small y, capital r small r small y small r capital y, this is the gamete. Here the gamete represent the pure parental is capital Y, capital R, capital Y is the pure, and here it is a small y is recessive, small r is also recessive. So now we are taking in dihybrid cross, that is one capital R, capital R, capital Y is crossed with small r, small y. This is the parental. Now in this gametes, if you are observed capital R, capital Y, this is one gamete, it is resembled to the parent. But here capital R, small y, capital R is for one parent, and capital Y is small y is for another parent. So that's why it is a recombinant. And similarly, small r is belongs to this parent and capital Y belongs to this parent. So it is also a recombinant. And small r, small y, so it is related to this parent. So parental type is 2 and recombinant type or 2 are formed during crossing over. The independent assessment of genes occurs in the following two situations. Independent assessment: if the genes are present on different chromosomes, then it leads to the independent assessment. If genes are so far apart on the same chromosome, so on the same chromosome, if genes are present at a particular distance, far distance, so that crossing over always occurs. So in that chromosome, when genes are present, already we discussed in previous video, crossing over is directly proportional to the distance between the genes. So here we are saying that genes are present far distance, that means distance is more. As a result, crossing over occurs. And in other words, 50% recombinant types of gametes are produced. So if genes are present far distance, linkage is loose. As a result, recombinants are formed. If genes are present close, then crossing over is absent, then recombinants are not formed. So now, see the representation of this crossing over. So homologous pair. So this is the one chromosome and it is another chromosome. So this without any shading, this one is maternal, and here this chromosome is a paternal, from father and it is from mother. So now the maternal chromosome having AA, BB, that means this chromatid having AB and allele of this is also small a, small b, and paternal chromosome having capital A, capital A, capital B, capital B. Now, when crossing over occurs between the chromatid of this one, this chromatid and this chromatid, this is the crossing over region. See now here, this region is called as the chiasmata, chiasma. The crossing over occurs between that. So when this crossing over is takes place, the part of the chromatid of maternal joins with the paternal chromosome. That means small b joins here, and capital B, part of this chromatid of paternal joins with the maternal. So now actually here what is present? A small a. So it become is small a. So now after crossing over, then the chiasmata is break and the rejoins, that rejoin is appears like this. Then when it undergo gamete formation, so crossing over is this, all the stages, homologous pairing, crossing over, and all it is takes place during prophase 1. During meiosis 1. So then after completion of this, then it undergo gamete formation. Again it will goes to the, then what happens during gamete formation, it will split into two. So it will goes into two cells, two gametes. Each gamete, one gamete is get capital A, capital B, this is a parental, and another gamete will get capital A and small b, it is due to the crossing over. And similarly, this maternal chromosome is also divides into two, that means two gametes, one gamete with that means having small a, capital B, and small a, small b. So now here capital A, capital B, it is a parental, paternal chromosome type. So this is one. Small a, small b, it is a maternal chromosome, that is like a parent, it is one. And capital A, small b, it is new combination. Small a, capital B, it is a new combination. That's why these two are the recombinants. So out of four, two are recombinants. That means 50% is a recombinant and remaining two are the parental. 50% is the parental combination. So the total recombinant type 50% and the parental type 50% gametes are formed during crossing over. Significance of crossing over. due to crossing over, recombination of genes occurs to being about new triads in individuals, thus playing an important factor in triads of the offspring from sexual reproduction. So simply we can say that due to the crossing over, it play an important role to get a new triad, new character in the individuals from the sexual reproduction. So crossing over is an important phenomena during sexual reproduction. We cannot find this crossing over in asexual reproduction. Now, second significance, due to recombination, a new species can evolve due to genetic material exchange. For example, this technique has been used in breeding of plants and animals to produce new varieties with desired characters. Third significance, the genetic distance between two locus is measured in centimorgon. So the genetic distance or a gene distance can be measured in centimorgons, which is related to the recombinant frequency, as 1 centimorgon is equal to 1% recombinant frequency. This distance in centimorgon is used in linkage maps or chromosome mapping. Thus, recombinant frequency helps in chromosome mapping and generation of linkage group or linkage maps. Fourth significance, crossing over has reinforced the concept of linear arrangement of chromosomes. So this crossing over explains the concept of that arrangement of genes linearly on the chromosome. Morgan's experiment. Morgan and his group found that even when some genes are present on the same chromosome, some genes may be tightly linked while some may be loosely linked. The ones like genes white and yellow show only 1.3% recombination, while genes for white and miniature wings are loosely linked and have showed 37.2% recombination. So once recollect these 2 points, what the Morgan and his group found, on the same chromosome, some genes may be tightly linked while some genes may be loosely linked. So then what is their observation? The genes for white and yellow shows only 1.3% recombination. That indicates that the genes for white and yellow are tightly linked. That's why recombination is less, because recombination depends on the crossing over. When genes are linked tightly, that means very near to each other, then crossing over is less. That's why recombination percentage is less. While the genes for white and miniature wings are loosely linked. That means suppose a white W and he can take M. Now the distance is 4. Suppose a white W and yellow, they are present like this. So here the both are very near. That's why recombination percentage is less. Whereas here, the white and miniature genes are present some far distance. That's why crossing over is more, then it gives more percentage of recombination, 37.2% recombination frequency. So based on this Mendel experiment, once observe this diagram, here we need to apply the linkage and recombination or crossing over linkage is inversely proportional to distance between the genes. Distance between genes on the same chromosome. Whereas crossing over is directly proportional to distance between genes. These two we need to remember, apply in this diagram. So now in cross A, so they are taken yellow and white, these are the recessive, and here yellow Y plus and W plus, this is a wild type and dominant one. So in cross A, they are taken wild type dominant with a recessive yellow and white. When they crossed, the F1 generation wild type and yellow type appears like this. And in F2 generation, that means in this, if you are observed, you will get the parental types and recombinant types are very less. That means when compared to here cross B, so white and miniature and wild type, dominant white and miniature wild type, and here the gamete formation. And when you are observed in the gametes, the parental type of gametes are 62.8% and recombinant type of gametes is 37.2. So this only we are discussed in previous. Here in cross B, the recombinant type is 37.2%. Whereas here the recombinant type is only 1.3%. It is depending on these two concepts, linkage and crossing over. See here, the genes on the chromosome are located very near in this cross A. If you are observed Y plus and W plus in wild type, these genes distance is very less. And here also the gene distance is very less. That means when compared to this cross B, the W is located here. See the distance between these two. So means in cross B, the chromosome, the genes present on the chromosome are somewhat far distance. But whereas in cross A, very near to each other. So when distance is less, linkage is more. Linked genes cannot undergo crossing over. That's why recombinant is less. But here the linkage is very less because of far distance. That's why they undergo crossing over. Then recombinant percent is more in this. So results of the two dihybrid crosses conducted by Morgan, what we saw in the previous slide. So cross A shows a cross between a gene Y and W. And cross B shows the cross between white and miniature. So here white and yellow, first cross, and in cross B, white and miniature. The dominant wild type alleles are represented with a capital. That is, suppose W plus indicates that it is dominant, and M plus indicates the dominant, and Y plus indicates dominant, and small y plus it is dominant. So these are the dominants, wild types. So the strength of linkage between Y and small w, small y and small w, is higher. So that means because they are present very near to, tightly linked. And whereas the strength of linkage between capital W and M is less than small y and small w. So that's why we can observe more recombinant percentage here, 37.2%, whereas here the recombinant percentage is 1.3%. Mapping of the chromosomes, genetic or linkage maps. Alfred Stewartant, he is the student of Morgan, used the frequency of recombination between the gene pairs on the same chromosome as a measure of distance between the genes and mapped their position on the chromosome. So he used the frequency of recombination between what? Between gene pairs on the same chromosome. For what? As a measure of distance between the genes, and help to map their position on the chromosome. A linkage map depicts the order and the relative distance between the various genes can be made. So what it relieves? The linkage map depicts or explains the order and the relative distance between the genes present on the chromosome. Linkage map can be constructed without looking at the genes. Remember that, without looking at the genes, they construct the linkage map or chromosome simply by making suitable crosses and by analyzing the characteristics of the progeny. So what we are saying in first line, linkage map can be constructed without looking at the genes. Then how they will make this linkage map? So linkage maps, they are constructed by making suitable crosses and by analyzing the characteristics of the offsprings, they can construct the linkage maps. The basis of linkage maps. First basis, greater the distance between two genes, more likely they are going to separate due to crossing over. The rate of separation is an index to determine the distance between them. Basis 2. Closer the genes on the chromosome, more likely they will stay together, or less likely that crossing over will occur between them. So if genes are very closer, crossing over is less or negligible, and they are stay together and they inherited together. The basis 3. If a recombination frequency in two genes is less than 50%, it indicates the genes are located on the same chromosome and they are linked genes. Fourth basis, the frequency of crossing over is directly proportional to the relative distance of the genes on the chromosomes. Here it is, some key points of this mapping of chromosomes or linkage maps or genetic maps. More crossing over is equal to more distance between the two genes. Then we can observe more crossing over. Less crossing over indicates the less distance between the two genes. Now, crossing over frequency is equal to recombination frequency or percentage of individuals showing recombinations. Now, frequency of recombination is equal to number of recombinant gametes divided by total number of genes. Then you will get the frequency of recombination. How to calculate the frequency of recombination? Frequency of recombination is equal to number of recombinant gametes divided by total number of genes. Then you will get the frequency of recombination. Here some important points related to this chromosomal mapping or linkage mapping. One map unit MU is equal to 1% of recombinant phenotypes. So 1 MU is equal to 1% of recombinant phenotypes. So a map unit is called as centimorgon. What is a map unit? A map unit is called a centimorgon. That indicates small c, capital M. Why it is given? Because in the honor of T.H. Morgans, because linkage term and it is discovered by Morgan. Honor to the Morgan. The map unit is represented with a centimorgon. 100 centimorgans is equal to the 1 morgan. So we can write 100 centimorgans is equal to 1 morgan. So here it is, the last slide of this chapter, but it may be last, but it is very important in the examination point. So here there are different columns are given, that is number of triads, hybrid and experiment, name, type of gametes, number of zygotes or offsprings are formed, number of phenotypes, number of genotypes, phenotypic ratio, genotypic ratio. That means we are studied monohybrid and dihybrid cross. And for this table, we are added the trihybrid cross also. So number of triads hybrid, that means how many number of characters we are considered. So that is first one is one character here. We are considering the one character. Here it is only one character. So studying a one pair of contrasting character, that is monohybrid cross. So that experiment is monohybrid cross. Now types of gametes we are represented with a 2 to the power of n. Remember this formula, 2 to the power of n. Here n is represent number of triads we are considered. Here 2 to the power of n. Here n is equal to number of triads. So we are considering only one triad, that is 2 to the power of 1. Then we can get the 2 gametes. Then number of zygotes or offsprings are formed. Number of, that means each zygote develops into one individual. So number of offsprings are formed, gamete square. So here In monohybrid cross, how many gametes are formed? Two gametes are formed. That gamete square, you will get the number of individuals. Two gametes are formed, two square, then it become four individuals are formed during monohybrid cross, that you can see in F2 generation. Now, number of phenotypes, 2 to the power of n. Again, here n represent 2 to the power of 1. That means 1 is triad. So 2 to the power of n is equal to number of triads. 2 to the power of 1, it become what? It become 2. 2 phenotypes, Stahl and Dorff phenotypes. Then number of genotypes. So everywhere we are using 2, but here for genotypes we are considering 3 to the power of n. Genotypes 3 to the power of n. N is equal to again character, number of triads we are considering. So remember here, anywhere 2 to the power of n, 2 to the power of n, 3 to the power of n, in all these three, n, small n, is equal to number of character. Number of triads. Number of triads. So if you consider one, it may be 1 monohybrid, 2 dihybrid, 3 trihybrid. So now let's come. So here n is equal to number of triads, 1 triad, 3 to the power of n, 3 genotypes. If you see that Tall and Dorff, it is crossed. 3 genotypes are formed, capital T 1, capital T small t 2, small t 1. So total 3 genotypes. So genotypic ratio 1:2, 2:1. Okay, now let's come to the second one. Same apply. Number of triads, two characters are considered. Then it is called as dihybrid cross, that experiment. Now types of gametes are formed, 2 to the power of n. N here, number of characters, 2 to the power of 2. 4 gametes are formed. Then number of offsprings, that is gamete square. So gametes are 4, 4 square, 16 individuals are formed. Number of phenotypes, 2 to the power of n. So that is n is number of triads. That means number of phenotypes, 4 phenotypes. 4 phenotypes. Number of genotypes, 3 to the power of n. So that means n is here 2. N is in this 3 to the power of n, here n is equal to 2 characters, that is 3 square, that means 9 phenotypes are formed, 9 genotypes are formed, phenotypes 4, 9 genotypes are formed. And phenotypic ratio 3:1, monohybrid ratio square, then 9:3:1. And genotypic ratio 1:2, 2:1, monohybrid square. Then you can get this. See, genotypes, how many we are say? 9 genotypes are 9. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 genotypes. Now come to the trihybrid cross. So in this trihybrid cross, then the considering triad characters are 3. So then that is a trihybrid cross. Now types of gametes, 2 to the power of n. Here n is equal to 3. That means 2 to the power of 3. 8 gametes are formed. So number of offsprings, gamete square. 8 gametes are formed. 8 square, that is 64 individuals are formed. Number of phenotypes, again 2 to the power of n. N is equal to 3 here. That means 2 to the power of 3, 8 phenotypes. You can remember that number of phenotypes is always equal to the number of gametes. Clear? Number of phenotypes is always equal to the number of gametes. See, in first monohybrid cross, number of phenotypes 2, number of gametes 2. Dihybrid cross, number of gametes 4, number of phenotypes 4. Now, trihybrid cross, number of gametes 8, number of phenotypes 8. So, in every cross, monohybrid, dihybrid, tri, tetra, penta, whatever may be, number of gametes is always equal to the number of phenotypes. Now, number of genotypes, here we need to take 3 to the power of n is the number of genotype formula. So here n is equal to number of triads. So number of triads here it is considered is 3, not 2. It is 3 trihybrid cross. 3 to the power of 3. Then it becomes 27. 3 into 3 into 3, 27. Then phenotypic ratio 3:1 square. Is it correct? 3:1. Here n is equal to number of characters. 3:1 cube. Then you will get the phenotypic ratio. Next, genotypic ratio 1:2, 2:1. To the power of 3, then you will get the genotypic ratio. So in our exams, there is no phenotypic and genotypic ratio in our syllabus, but up to here we need to find. So it is a very important in the concept of competitive examinations. So number of gametes in monohybrid, number of gametes, how to find. So number of gametes as well as number of phenotypes we will find 2 to the power of n. Remember this. Here n is equal to number of characters we are considering. And number of genotypes we will find by using 3 to the power of n. Here also n is a number of triads. 3 to the power of n gives the genotype creation, that means genotypes, and 2 to the power of n it gives gamete number as well as phenotypes number. Genotype we are always calculate by using 3 to the power of n. Thank you. The lesson is concluded. Tomorrow onwards, we will discuss competitive